There's a place in your heart, and I
thank
know
you, that's a call for this tree.
I thank you for everything that you gave me, the food and the toy. Thank you, Dr. Cole.
I want to tell Dr. Cole that thank you for everything that you have done for us, for this chimney, this kid tree, and I always look forward to come to this tree.
Thank you so much for everything.
And I just want to tell Dr. Cole thanks for everything, because every year I look forward to this tree. I just want to tell him thanks and God bless him.
Make a better place. Heal the world. Make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for living, make a better place for you and for me.
Our guardian angels are closer to us than anything except the love of God. To many from all walks of life, this has proven itself true in the person of Dr. Lloyd Cole, philanthropist and unsung hero of the Jamaican social fabric, a child born in St. Elizabeth, Jamaica on April 1st, 1938, destined not only for greatness, but also to give back to his community and the island at large. As a young child, Dr. Cole attended Park Mountain Elementary and spent his early years of growth, education, and work in London. Cole attended various schools and polytechnics in London, creating and maintaining a brilliant record before joining the British Medical Research Council at the Royal Postgraduate Medical School, Hammersmith Hospital, London, as a young research scientist for 3 years. Cole became the only black person to date to work at the British Medical Research Council. Cole returned to Jamaica in 1965. By 1970, he had completed his medical degree at the University of the West Indies. Since then, Cole has worked with the UWI Hospital, the Kingston Public Hospital, and Victoria Jubilee Hospitals, other public and private hospitals in Jamaica, and Port of Spain General Hospital in Trinidad. He also engages in private medical practice and extensive community service. Custis Arden speaks to his social contribution to education.
Well, it's a foundation that he has set up where he gives grants to children, I would think needy children, and children who are potentially bright and has the ambition, but maybe not the wherewithal to go along. He not only just gives the award, but he follows through. He makes sure the student has what it takes to follow through. And he has had some very successful stories. I'm sure if you speak to him, he will tell you some of his success stories with his students.
Cole's medical practice has strong altruistic qualities and focuses on working among the poor and less fortunate in both the public hospitals and in community private practice.
His benevolence in education, the award of scholarships and all that, is quite notable. In a couple of sentences, Dr. Lloyd Cole is an outstanding Jamaican of his generation and would be of any generation. Would there were more men like him? Lately, he is been attracting attention as conceptualizer of a project of great potential, having to do with the establishment of a dry dock, and I hope it succeeds. I know that he has long been attempting to get government and private sector support for this, and I hear that this is finally materializing, and I'm very glad to hear it.
How would you describe his father?
An outstanding Jamaican and a plainly decent man who it has been my great privilege to know. My impression is that he considers his real reward as lying in the success of others who he has helped over the years, and I think that that's a very commendable accident.
Cole has established one of the largest Christmas streets in the Caribbean. Since 1984, over 30,000 people receive chair and gifts from Dr. Cole's effort annually on Boxing Day. Cole has phenomenally impacted the lives of many inner-city youth over the last nearly 30 years. They express their thanks to Dr. Cole.
Basically, I'm 29, and I've known that tree to be keeping from around 29 years now.
And he makes sure that the tree for everybody, for the whole Jamaica, people come from near and far. You know what I say? All walks of life. Because them know say a Dr. Cole treat. So it obviously is a big man in a Jamaica itself.
When the treat occurs, like one of the biggest things in here, and it's an asset that Stanpipe has been holding for over 25 years, and we just love Dr. Cole.
It's a good treat. Everybody in this community look forward to it because that's the only, what should I say, the only entertainment we have on that day.
It is very fun and nice, and we look forward to go to it every Christmas.
I want him to keep doing the good job that he is doing, for not just for us, but also for wider Stanpipe and also the wider Jamaica.
Affectionately known as Doc, one woman relates the story of how he saved her life.
When I was sick with cancer, that was 10 years ago, I got him for sick leave to go to my daughter's graduation, and he said $1,500. I said, Doc, I don't have you. Give me a right through checkup, and him find the lump in my breast and send me to cancer society. Him saved my life 7 years now since me do my what you call it? The operation and the chemotherapy. So I'm a survivor. And it's all because of Dr. Cole. Dr. Cole, thank you for everything you have done for Stanpipe community and myself especially. You are the best. Thank you for saving my life.
His personal foundation, the Dr. Lloyd Cole Foundation, was formed in 1994 for the primary focus of assisting poor, promising pupils from primary to secondary and high schools. Cole has adopted 8 schools in Kingston and rural Jamaica.
He has worked assiduously in all areas of school life. One of the most outstanding things that he has done is in 1994, he set up the Dr. Lloyd Cole Foundation for Education. What this is, it caters to needy students from the school. As a matter of fact, there are 6 schools that he has associated with over the years, and each student, we have 3 students coming from these schools that get scholarship.
Dr. Cole's affiliation with Hope Valley started when he started extending scholarships to students who then did the common entrance and now the grade 6 achievement test, GSAT, and each year he has given 3 scholarships. And I think what most persons don't know is that his award is always given out on his birthday. So he doesn't think much about receiving, but he does think a lot about giving.
As a result of his scholarship, we have gotten the students to depict a very good attendance record here at school. And all students are vying to be a possible contender. So they try to ensure that not just the academics is intact, but their behavior and attendance. And we have seen marked improvement in that. Matter of fact, his scholarship has served as a motivating factor for our children. And most importantly, the parents are very grateful for the scholarships being provided.
I have understood that all of this comes from his personal reserves. And what would have driven him to do this is only one of a kind. Again, even as a more senior doctor working at the Kingston Public Hospital, I remember him also launching fundraising drives to assist in the development and refurbishing of the hospital. He's clearly, someone rooted in the consciousness of, his environment, the people and those who serve, and wants to really help to improve that sort of setting. So I really admire the individual for that.
To date, Cole has granted over 700 scholarships to needy youth through the foundation, in addition to other personal scholarships granted alongside New Providence Primary, Augustown Primary, Hope Valley Experimental, Park Mountain Primary, New Day Primary and Junior High, Richmond Primary, McIntosh Memorial, Mona Primary. Not only the direct recipients of his philanthropy have much to say about him, the media has lauded him for years for being a stalwart contributor to Jamaican youth and development. Both major political parties laud him as well.
I would like to commend Dr. Lloyd Cole, who is a community man, started this street 28 years ago with just a few children, focused on the standpipe area. But what has happened that it has grown so large, most persons from Eastern St. Andrew is at this street, and I really want to commend him for this excellent move of treating the community, and for I'm seeing people from various areas who normally sometimes don't get along here partying, having a good time. And the early part with the little children in the evenings, and then now in the later hours, the older persons. And I personally want to say how thankful I am for Dr. Cole for doing this for the constituency. These are the kind of community leaders that we need, who truly love the community and give back to the community. And he's a leader, he's a mentor and an example to our wider constituents. And I really want to applaud you, Dr. Cole, and wish you all the best, and hope that next year you will invite me again to participate in this grand tree.
In 1985, Jamaica was rocked by extensive fires which destroyed several departments of the KPH and Victoria Jubilee Hospital. In that time of despair, up to the mid-80s, KPH had no intensive care unit. However, through the KPH Victoria Jubilee Hospital Restoration Project, and courtesy of the American Friends of Jamaica, Dr. Cole donated some US$1 million to build the KPH Victoria Jubilee Hospital in When asked what continues to motivate him despite the many negative stories we hear about Jamaica every day, to continue to support and sponsor youth and development, this is what Dr. Lloyd Cole had to say.
I love Jamaica too much to see our young boys and our young girls walking on the street begging for money and begging for a job which does not exist. People, some of them who get in university, come out, can't find a job. I have this problem here daily, people coming, giving me a resume. And what do? I can't do anything about it. There's no jobs. And they sit on the corner doing absolutely nothing, just waiting for the nightfall to go and involve in crime and other things. I hate that. I cannot stand it. I beg Jamaica, I plead with the rulers, people in high places, the movers and shakers. It's not for Lloyd Cole, rather. It's for Jamaica, land we love.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my needs. Only place to be, and so I learned to depend.
Mm-hmm.
It's a long, long journey, so stay by my side. When we walk through the storm, you'll be my guide.
When asked what continues to motivate him, despite the many negative stories we hear about Jamaica every day, to continue to support and sponsor youth and development, this is what Dr. Lloyd Cole had to say.
I love Jamaica too much to see our young boys and our young girls walking on the street begging for money and begging for a job which does not exist. People, some of them who get in university, come out, can't find a job. I have this problem here. Daily people coming, giving me a resume. And what do? I can't do anything about it. There's no jobs. And they sit on the corner doing absolutely nothing, just waiting for the nightfall to go on involving crime and other things. I hate that. I cannot stand it. I beg Jamaica. I plead with the rulers, people in high places, the movers and shakers. It's not for Lloyd Cole, rather. It's for Jamaica, land we love.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my needs. Lonely place to be, and so I learned to